Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to Masjid Al-Falah on this blessed Friday and thank you for choosing our masjid to perform your Friday prayers. Selamat datang ke Masjid Al-Falah pada hari Jumaat yang penuh barakah ini dan terima kasih kerana memilih Masjid Al-Falah sebagai tempat menunaikan fardu Jumaat anda. For your information, the khatib and imam for today will be Ustaz Ibrahim bin Samat. While the muazzin will be Ustaz Muhammad Zul Faizal bin Siddiq. Sermon will be in English, insyaAllah. Khatib dan imam tengah hari ini ialah yang berbahagia Ustaz Ibrahim bin Samat. Manakala Bilal ialah Ustaz Muhammad Zul Faizal bin Siddiq. Khutbah akan disampaikan dalam bahasa Inggeris, insyaAllah. The topic for today's khutbah is, our nation's prosperity is a joint responsibility. Tajuk khutbah pada hari ini adalah Kemakmuran Negara Tanggungjawab Bersama. While awaiting the azan that will be called in a few minutes time at 1:12 PM, allow us to make a few announcements. Sementara menantikan azan yang akan dikumandangkan pada jam 1:12 tengah hari, di sini ada beberapa pengumuman. Giving zakat is part of being a Muslim. If you have a minimum savings of $4,808 for a year or more, you are eligible to give zakat. Masjid Al-Falah welcomes your zakat and fidyah. InsyaAllah, our amils are always ready to assist you in all your zakat inquiries. Membayar zakat adalah sebahagian dari kehidupan kita sebagai seorang Muslim. Jika anda mempunyai wang simpanan sekurang-kurangnya $4,808 dalam setahun, anda sudah berlayak untuk memberikan zakat. Penerimaan zakat harta dan fidyah dijalankan di masjid ini sepanjang tahun. Bagi tuan-tuan dan juga puan-puan yang ingin menunaskan zakat, ataupun mempunyai sebarang pertanyaan tentang zakat, sila berhubung dengan amil-amil kami yang sedia membantu anda. Our Ibadah Department is conducting the pantry network on every Thursday starting at 12:30 PM until Zuhur prayers. We will be discussing various topics and questions regarding Islam and current affairs. We would like to encourage our blessed jemaah to participate in the program. Thank you for your attendance. Unit Ibadah ada mengadakan sesi The Pantry Network pada setiap hari Khamis bermula pada jam 12:30 hari hingga ke solat zuhur. Sesi ini akan membincangkan topik-topik dan persoalan mengenai Islam dan hal ehwal semasa. Kami amat-amat menggalakkan penglibatan tuan-tuan dan juga puan-puan dalam program ini. Terima kasih di atas kehadiran anda. Dear Jemaah, we are pleased to announce that our zuhur kuliah have started and are in full swing. All jemaah are warmly invited to attend the kuliah and may you benefit from all of our kuliah provided. Do like and subscribe to our YouTube channel Al-Falah TV for more videos. Untuk makluman para jemaah sekalian, kuliah harian pada waktu zuhur di Masjid Al-Falah sudah dibuka secara keseluruhannya. Para jemaah dipersilakan hadir dan memanfaatkan semua kuliah yang ada. Kami juga mengajak para jemaah untuk like dan langgani saluran YouTube kami iaitu Al-Falah TV. Come and join us for monthly Qiyamulail on Saturday morning, 25th of August 2018 here at Masjid Al-Falah. InsyaAllah, we will begin at 4 AM in the morning with 10 raka'ats of tahajud and 3 raka'ats of witr. All jemaah are warmly invited to attend and see you here, insyaAllah. Masjid Al-Falah akan mengadakan program Qiyamulail pada pagi hari Sabtu, 25 Ogos 2018. InsyaAllah, program Qiyamulail akan bermula pada jam 4 pagi dengan 10 raka'at tahajud dan diakhiri dengan 3 raka'at witr. Semua jemaah dijemput hadir dan semoga Allah melimpahkan rahmatnya kepada kita semua. Amin. Jemaah yang dihormati, insyaAllah Masjid Al-Falah akan mengadakan majlis syarahan agama pada hari Ahad 19 Ogos 2018 pada jam 9 pagi. Syarahan akan disampaikan oleh yang berbahagia Datuk Ustaz Badli Shah bin Alauddin dengan tajuk Berkorban Demi Kebahagiaan. Sekian muslimin dan muslimat dijemput hadir. Terima kasih. Our Islamic Learning Department has already conducted a Solihah Dari series titled Life Lessons from Wives of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on every Tuesday from 7 August 2018. The class will be conducted in English by Ustazan Liana Musfira. Unit Mempelajaran Islam sedang menganjurkan kelas khas bagi muslimah yang diberi tajuk Life Lessons from Wives of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam pada setiap hari Selasa mulai daripada 7 Ogos 2018. Kelas ini bakal dibimbing oleh Ustazah Liana Musfira di dalam bahasa Inggeris. We'll be conducting another class titled Being Muslim Module 3 on every Friday starting on the 24th of August 2018 from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. It will be conducted by Ustaz Abdul Matin bin Abu Bakar for 5 weeks. The class aims to provide a practical and useful knowledge that can help clarify what it means to be a Muslim. Kami juga akan menganjurkan kelas Being Muslim Modul 3 pada setiap hari Jumaat bermula pada 24 Ogos 2018 dari jam 7.30 malam hingga 9.30 malam. Kelas ini bakal dimimbing oleh Ustaz Abdul Matin bin Abu Bakar selama 5 minggu. Kelas ini bertujuan untuk menyediakan pengetahuan praktikal yang dapat membantu menjelaskan ertinya menjadi seorang Muslim. Another class by the Love Islam series on Fiqh Essentials titled Money, Business and Investment Matters will begin on Monday, 27th of August 2018 from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. It will be conducted by Ustaz Muhammad Nuzaihan bin Hamdan for 4 weeks. For more information, you can proceed to our counter or contact our Islamic Learning Officer, Ms. Nadia Osman at 6235-3172. Thank you. Kami juga akan menganjurkan kelas dari siri Fiqh Essentials yang diberi tajuk Money, Business and Investment Matters. InsyaAllah, kelas ini akan bermula pada hari Isnin 27 Ogos pada 2018 dari jam 7.30 malam hingga ke 9.30 malam. Kelas ini bakal dibimbing oleh Ustaz Muhammad Nuzaihan bin Hamdan selama 4 minggu. Bagi yang berminat, bolehlah mendaftarkan diri di kaunter resepsi kami atau hubungi pegawai Nadia Osman di talian 6235-3172 buat butiran lanjut. Terima kasih. Asatiza Youth Network will be conducting a free consultation session at Masjid Al-Falah. It is for those who seek religious guidance on issues related to questionable or problematic religious doctrines or concepts. The session will help to clarify the issues of religious political concepts such as of jihad, khilafah, from the mainstream Islamic perspective and guide anyone who may have concerns on online religious materials. To join this session, you may arrange for an appointment by contacting us at 6235-3172 or you may also drop by the office counter for walk-in registrations. Asatiza Youth Network ada menawarkan sesi perundingan secara percuma di Masjid Al-Falah. Sesi ini adalah buat mereka yang ingin mencari panduan mengenai isu-isu dan konsep agama yang bermasalah. Sesi ini juga akan membantu menjelaskan isu-isu dan konsep agama seperti jihad, khilafah dari perspektif Islam yang sebenar. Membimbing sesiapa sahaja yang mungkin mempunyai keprihatinan terhadap bahan-bahan agama di laman siber. Bagi yang berminat untuk menyertai sesi ini, bolehlah hubungi kami di talian 6235-3172 atau datang ke kaunter pejabat untuk pendaftaran secara walk-in. The registration for exhumation of graves at Chua Chu Kang Muslim Cemetery, Phase 6 has begun. NEA and MUIS would like to call upon the Muslim community to come forward to make claims on the remains of their family buried in Block 6, 7, 8, 9, 19 and 20. Next of kin can book an appointment for registration online at pusara.sg and present yourself at Masjid Pusara Aman on your appointed date and time. You can still walk in and register at Masjid Pusara Aman from 8:30 a.m. to 12 noon, Monday to Friday. However, priority for verification will be given to online bookings. Registration is closed on Sundays and public holidays. Closing date for registration is on 25th of September 2018. For more information, please call 6238-4504. Pendaftaran bagi pengembuian semula kubur-kubur di tanah perkuburan Chua Chu Kang Fasa 6 telah bermula. NEA dan MUIS ingin menyeru masyarakat Islam untuk tampil ke hadapan bagi membuat tuntutan ke atas mayat arwah ahli keluarga yang dikemubikan di Blok 6, 7, 8, 9, 19 dan 20. Para waris boleh memilih tarikh dan waktu pendaftaran secara online di laman pusara.sg. Waris perlu hadir pada tarikh dan waktu yang telah dipilih di Masjid Pusara Aman. Para waris masih boleh datang tanpa temu janji ke Masjid Pusara Aman dari jam 8.30 pagi hingga 12.30 hari, Isnin hingga Jumaat. keutamaan akan diberikan kepada waris yang membuat tempahan bagi pendaftaran secara online. Pendaftaran ditutup pada setiap Ahad dan cuti umum. Tarikh tutup pendaftaran adalah pada 25 September 2018. Untuk makluman lanjut, sila hubungi talian 6235-45-4. We are pleased to assist our partners in their fundraising efforts. Rahmatan Lil Alamin Foundation, RLAF, will be collecting funds during today's Friday prayers. Volunteers holding their donation boxes can be found at the front entrances of the masjid. Please assist them in their fundraising efforts and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your generosity. Kami dengan sukacitanya akan membantu rakan-rakan kami dalam usaha mengumpulkan dana mereka. Yayasan Rahmatan Lil Alamin akan mengumpul dana mereka pada hari Jumaat ini. Sukarelawan memegang tabung derma boleh didapati di pintu masuk hadapan masjid. Marilah bersama kita membantu Yayasan Rahmatan Lil Alamin dalam usaha pengumpulan dana mereka dan semoga Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala memberikan anda ganjaran sepenuhnya. Let us remind ourselves that a gracious society isn't built in a day. It's built by one gracious individual at a time and one gracious act at a time. Let us be more gracious by not parking our vehicles in front of the masjid and along the pavement. Let us park our vehicles at the car parks nearby and thank you for your kind cooperation in this matter. Masyarakat madani yang bertimbang rasa tidak dibina dalam sehari. Ia dibina oleh setiap individu pada satu masa dan pada satu perbuatan yang baik pada satu masa. Ayo kita menzahirkan sifat bertimbang rasa dengan tidak meletakkan kenderaan di hadapan masjid dan di sepanjang kawasan kaki lima. Untuk kemudahan anda, tempat letak kereta berdekatan dengan Masjid Al-Falah mempunyai bilangan tempat parkir yang lebih besar. Kerjasama jemaah dalam perkara ini amat kami hargai. We seek your kind cooperation to please keep the masjid clean and to use the water wisely. We also advise you to please take proper care of your belongings. Di sini, kami ingin memohon kerjasama anda agar dapat sama-sama kita menjaga kebersihan masjid dan menjimatkan penggunaan air. Kami juga berharap agar tuan-tuan dapat menjaga barang-barang perimandi anda semasa khutbah dan solat nanti. On behalf of Masjid Al-Falah Mosque Management Board, we would like to wish all Hajj pilgrims a safe journey and a mabrur Hajj. May Allah accept your obedient deeds and may the mercy and blessings of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala be with you, your family and your friends during these auspicious days and continue to be always blessed. Bagi pihak Lembaga Pentadbir Masjid Al-Falah, kami mendoakan semoga semua tetamu Allah yang menunaikan haji tahun ini dipermudahkan segala urusan ibadah di Tanah Suci Makkah dan insya-Allah mendapat haji yang mabrur serta selamat pergi dan selamat kembali ke tanah air seperti anak kecil yang baru dilahirkan. Semoga Allah menganugerahkan kesabaran dan ketakwaan semasa menghadapi segala kesukaran dan mihnah di Tanah Suci. Doakan kami yang tinggal di belakang ini akan sampai pula giliran kami menyahut panggilan Baitullah di tahun-tahun hadapan. Amin. We have a few requests for us to recite Surah Al-Fatiha on behalf of the following. Di sini terdapat beberapa permintaan untuk sama-sama kita bacakan Surah Al-Fatiha bagi pihak Al-Marhumin wal-Marhumat. Rahma binti Muhammad, Haja Maimuna binti Haji Omar, Datin Haja Siti Hara binti Haji Taha, Haji Abdullah Faqih Ahmad, Haji Syafi Ali, Haji Syafi bin Misrullah, Haji Ridwan Ibrahim, Haji Surina Ibrahim, Haji Lizwana binti Buhar, Ustaz Syed Abdullah Ahmad Al-Jufri, Omar Salim Talib, Tihin Haji Abdul Rahman bin Taha, Haji Rukia binti Syafi, Syakila Begum binti Haji Abdul Ghani, Sultan Atik, Haji Asana Kardin, Haji Fidahuddin Taibeli, Haji Bibahu Shin Taibeli, Haji Abdul Ghafu Mahmud, Haji Lumri bin Bahrum, Haji Safiyah binti Maksum, Haji Siti Zahara binti Syekh Hasan, Haji Salma binti Said,
Syi'alauddin bin Muhammad Yusuf, Hajjah Nur binti Haji Muhammad Basharail, Farhain Azizi, Haji Uthman Abdullah, Hajjah Numala, Haji Muhammad Zaini, Haji Arifin, Haji Tain, Haji Abdul Khair Muhammad Dun, Salim Selamat, Syed Muhammad Amin Sharaf, Raja Nulini binti Raja Abdul Jalil, Faizal bin Abdullah, Muhammad Daud Sidat, Haji Nusina binti Haji Muhammad Yusuf, Tengku Yusni binti Tengku Muhammad Yusuf, Haji Selamat bin Ashari, Haji Ibrahim bin Ashari, Haji Nulaila Abdullah, Syed Muhammad Ali Abu Bakar Mata, Aisyah binti Syed Ali Mata, Ustaz Osman Jantan, Syed Yahya bin Syed Ali bin Yahya, Bada Hamid, Haji Nias Muhammad Shah, Haji Muhammad Yusri bin Rabi, Setiawati Hudaya, Muhammad Nur Azim bin Muhammad Nur Hazwan, Haji Mamuna binti Mat, Syed Sidi Aidid bin Syed Abdul Aidid, Haji Dora Harahab binti Haji Johari Harahab, Fatimah Jannah, Haji Sutlia binti Ali, Zainal Omar, Zawiyah Haji Dulmat, Haji Muhammad Akib, Imam Abdul Ghani, Haji Zubidah Mitasim, Ahmad Hassan Sadiq, Farida Sadiq, Ibrahim Ali, Muhammad Shah Ismail, Haji Tad bin Haji Putih, Sharifah Aulia Indid, Syed Abdul Aidid, Sultan Abdul Qadir, Syamsuddin Johan, Yap Cimih, Haji Ismail bin Maknum Rejo, Haji Rukia Sastro Rejo, Haji Hamidah Abdullah, Syirin Suraya binti Muhammad Salihuddin, Haji Ronani binti Sulaiman Siregar, Haji Ramla Marzuki, Haji Rashidi Rawi Abdul Rahman Taha, Haji Muhammad Taha Rendah, Haji Jamila binti Awang Hussein, Haji Muhammad Yusuf bin Hussein, Haji Aminah binti Hassan, Haji Semanu binti Haji Muhammad Yusuf, Haji Mahmud bin Saleh, Haji Yasin bin Haji Hashim, Haji Fatimah binti Ramsan, Habib Muhammad bin Idrus Al-Habshi, Sheikha Suluma Al-Habshi, Habib Idrus Al-Habshi, Haji Muhammad Nur bin Abdullah, Haji Nurahan binti Ahmad Kaimin, Haji Nusina, Haji Mazda binti Haji Abdul Rahman, Haji Kiatuni Johan, Haji Saada binti Haji Abdul Rahman, Haji Abdullah bin Lasim, Haji Said Sulaiman Muhammad Tambik Putih, Haji Abdul Rahman bin Sabin, Haji Tumina binti Selamat, Haji Zakaria bin Abdul Rahman, Haji Nur Rashikin Abdullah, Haji Syed Sidi Aidid bin Syed Abdullah Aidid, Fatumah Al-Kasim, Haji Aisyah binti Haji Tain, Haji Abdul Rahman bin Ibrahim, Haji Cia binti Ismail, Haji Nurnila binti Haji Ali, Haji Kulsum binti Abdul Ghani, Haji Isa binti Haji Tain, Datin, Haji Nur Ashkim binti Abdullah, Haji Sani bin Abdul, Haji Mazda binti Haji Abdul Rahman, Muhammad Luqman bin Sayuti, Haji Karola bin Mansur, Haji Hussein bin Haji Yusuf, Haji Sarpura binti Sarjimin, Haji Juraima binti Juwani, Haji Hamid bin Haji Muhammad Nawabi, and also let us pray for the safety, wellness and well-being of, juga mari kita doakan kesihatan dan kesejahteraan untuk, Haji Musa Adnin sekeluarga, Haji Syed Anis Syahab sekeluarga, Sarima Tarmugi, Rudi Ardian, Masyita Abdullah, Alis Abdullah, Julia Harosa, Sabiah Haji Sulaiman, Habibah binti Muhammad Taib, Zubaidah binti Muhammad Taib, Haji Hawa bin Syed Ghani, Sultan Ismail Petra, Ibn Sultan Yahya Petra, Muhammad Nizam bin Rashid, Ghazalah Chaudhry and family, Haji Abdul Rahman bin Taib and keluarga, Haji Ahmad Mushiri bin Haji Abdul Rahman Taha, Haji Buhanuri Hassan sekeluarga, Haji Ghani Laldin, Haji Syamsuddin bin Ghafur, Atitani Abdullah, Abdullah Ibrahim, Amri Siregar, Haji Abdul Hamid bin Haji Abdul Karim, Raja Arsyad bin Raja Tun Uda, Khurunisa binti Abdul Rahman, Syed Ahmad Kabir, Sajita Hassan Al-Kabir, Haji Awang Saleh bin Awang Damik, Haji Nur Yusuf Ain bin Haji Muhammad Nur, Muhammad Amin Fikri, Saadiyah binti Jantan, Dr. Ahmad Mata sekeluarga, Mahmud bin Haji Muhammad Said, Nazaruddin bin Abdul Rahman, Khurunisa binti Nazaruddin, Zubaidah binti Muhammad Said, Khariani Kamik sekeluarga, Siraj Said keluarga, Arjuna Yunus bin Lakhia sekeluarga, Sulaiman Muhammad Abdul Aziz Al-Sharid, Humayun Muhammad Salih Al-Hamad, Zakir Mahmud Ahmad, Haji Abdul Rahman bin Haji Abdul Karim sekeluarga, Siti Zubaidah binti Hussein, Haji Osman Muhammad, Haji Anis Ahmad sekeluarga, Haji Zainal bin Haji Osman, Jasmine Abdullah sekeluarga, Muhammad Fadli bin Jasmine, Muhammad Farhan bin Jasmine, Haji Siti Hawa binti Haji Muhammad Taha, Haji Muhammad Jamil bin Umar, Muhammad Nur Hazwan bin Abdullah sekeluarga, Bapak Haji Andi Darussalam Tabusala, Haja Zainab binti Abdul Hamid, Haja Mazlan bin Sulaiman sekeluarga, Haja Roknani binti Sulaiman Siregar, Bapa Gunevi Hasam Jaya Semita, Ibu Siti Juab Fahmi Mukta Gunevi, Datin Haja Ida binti Haji Muhammad Nur, Rida Jasmin binti Abdul Rahman sekeluarga, Pihin Haji Abdul Rahman, Haji Karim sekeluarga, Jaiz bin Abdul Rahman, Rahim bin Muhammad Nur, Omar Usman Kuang, Fatimah binti Borhan, Shirozin Yungin Cyrus, Faridu and family, Robi and family, Anwardin son of Halil Rahman, Muhammad Pasha, Peter Schaefer, Muhammad Shah, Nur Hayati binti Mukhtar, Sanwan bin Raiz, Kemi bin Jamil, Haja Latifah binti Abdul Rahman, Anwardin bin Hayur Rahman and family, Shamsuddin bin Khairul Rahman and family, Abdul Majid bin Khairul Rahman and family, Surajuddin bin Khairul Rahman and family, Safiuddin bin Khairul Rahman and family, Salafuddin bin Khairul Rahman and family, Yasmin binti Zainun, Hajarib Rahman, Haja Delora Begum, Rashida Rahman and family, Haja Yahya Arun Edwards, Behin Jamil bin Omar, Syed Muhammad Ani Shahab Al-Haj, Haji Salman Karim and family, Behin Haji Suhur, Behin Haji Hurairah, Haji Muhammad Taha, Nujim Uskip Talib Iqshal, Haji Hifsa Begum, Muhammad Harith bin Abdullah, Belang Muhammad Zuraimi, Jiwalang Muhammad Zuraimi, Suryani binti Sungit, Muhammad Irfan Faris bin Muhammad Zuraimi, Muhammad Ishak bin Muhammad Zuraini, Ifa Nur Marini binti Muhammad Zuraini, Seri Marwani binti Salmani, Siti Marhani binti Salmani, Zahida binti Muhammad Nizar, Ahmad Ifwat bin Ahmad Kamal, Sahara binti Jantan, Nurzina binti Muhammad Zainoy, Nurzuyana binti Muhammad Zainoy, Muhammad Zurimi bin Muhammad Zainoy, Muhammad Zuraini binti Muhammad Zuraini bin Muhammad Zainoy, Arisa Kristina binti Abdullah, Nadia Eng binti Abdullah, Diana Natasha binti Azhar, Daniel Azri bin Azhar, Jordan Adam Lim, Al-Fatiha. Dear Jemaah, we seek your kind cooperation. Please move forward as much as possible for your Tahiyatul Masjid prayers and your Qobla prayers later and fill up the rows in front of you to make more space for brothers who are arriving later. Please keep silent during the sermon. Thank you. Para Jemaah, kami pohon kerjasama tuan-tuan, sila penuhkan saf yang di hadapan sebelum menunaikan solat Qobla supaya dapat memberi ruang kepada saudara kita yang tiba lewat. Para jemaah harap dapat menghayati khutbah yang disampaikan nanti. Terima kasih.
Subhanallah walhamdulillah wala ilaha illallah wallahu akbar wala haula wala quwwata illa billah wa sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa alihi wasallam. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله
إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
الحمد لله الغني الحميد وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وهو على كل شيء شهيد وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله المبعوث بالرحمة والقول السديد اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون Dear blessed Friday jemaah rahimakumullah, let us increase our taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us fulfill our obligations towards him and abstain from his prohibitions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us and our families strength in our iman and taqwa insha'Allah. Blessed Jumu'ah rahimakumullah, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions migrated to Medina, they were overwhelmed with a deep sense of longing for the city of Mecca. Imam Al-Bukhari in his Sahih narrated a story of the time when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered the city of Medina. One of his companions, Bilal ibn Rabah radiyallahu anhu, had been afflicted by severe illnesses. When his fever finally subsided, he expressed his longing for the city of Mecca by saying, "I wish that I could stay overnight in a valley wherein I would be surrounded by the trees of Idhir and Jalil. I wish that one day I could see the water of Mijannah, and I wish that one day the two mountains of Shamah and Tafil would appear to me." Sayyidina Bilal's words clearly expressed his love and longing for Mecca. Upon hearing this, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recited a prayer. Allahumma habib ilayna al-Madinah kahubbina Makkah aw ashad. O Allah, place in our hearts a love for Madinah similar to our love for Makkah or greater. Dear Jumaah rahimakumullah, loving one's country is an emotion that is shared by many. In the hadith mentioned earlier, it is apparent how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his sahaba longed for the city of Mecca, while also sharing an equal sense of endearment towards the city of Medina. As a reflection, how would we feel if we were forced to leave our homeland? How would we feel if we had to leave behind our families, friends, and relatives? And how do we remain positive in such difficult times and challenging situations? The Sahaba Ridwanullah alayhim expressed their love for the city of Makkah in a positive manner, and that is by contributing to the prosperity of the city of Medina. Dear Jemaah rahimakumullah, being a productive member of society is definitely one of the teachings of Allah's Prophet. The good which they have contributed to society is not limited to matters pertaining to the hereafter. It is also encompasses worldly matters as well. As an example, during the time of Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam, Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam had asked to be placed in a position of great responsibility due to his knowledge and expertise on the matter. Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in Surah Yusuf, ayah 55, ba'na'udzu billahi minasyaitonir rajim, qala ja'alni 'ala khaza'inil ard, inni hafizun 'alim. Prophet Yusuf said, appoint me over the storehouses of the land. Indeed, I will be a knowing guardian. According to Dr. Umar Sulaiman Al-Ashkar in his book, Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam lived in a society that was not familiar with Islam nor its teaching. Nevertheless, Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam requested to be appointed as treasurer of Egypt's agricultural wealth in order to protect his country from the oncoming drought. This proves that the act of preserving good and preventing harm is an important principle in Islam. A Muslim must uphold this principle in any country that he lives in, and he is constantly thinks of ways to contribute to society and improve its condition. In a society's efforts to improve its quality of life, every member has to play their part. We must work collectively, utilizing our efforts and individual strengths, while avoiding unhealthy competition, which will inevitably divide the community. Blessed Jumaah rahimakumullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Ar-Ra'd, ayah 11, فَعَرَوْزُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيْرُ مَا بِكَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيْرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Indeed, Allah will not change the condition of a people until they change what is in themselves. This ayah calls upon us to actively seek progress and make positive changes. We seek and we share knowledge. We spread mercy. We unite people, and so on. And it shows that we as Muslims are proactive and optimize our efforts toward achieving divinely guided success. And as a Muslim, we must not be passive, accepting a negative reality and uses tawakkal as an excuse. While the true meaning of tawakkal is submitting the outcome of one's affairs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after exercising maximum effort. Dear Jemaah rahimakumullah, being a productive member of society, we can also contribute constructive ideas and opinions. Voicing out opinions is highly encouraged in Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would frequently provide his companions with the opportunities to share their ideas. And this was also the practice of the generation that came after. They work hand in hand and shared opinion in services in service of the greater good. And no matter how intelligent an individual may be, combining the experience, wisdom, and knowledge of many can only bring them closer together. It fosters prosperity and unity when it comes to issues of public interest. However, it is important to note that while we voice our views and opinions, be it concurring or opposing, we must refrain from using harsh words and foul language. Remember that even if we have a strong desire to provide feedback and suggestion, it must be guided by wisdom, knowledge, and responsibility. Dear Jemaah Rahimakumullah, loving our country and contributing to its prosperity is a religious requirement. The Sahaba Ridwanullah Ta'ala Alayhim, in addition to teaching religious knowledge and spreading Islam, they contributed to the growth of Medina through trade and agriculture. If we wish progress and prosperity upon the future generation of our country and our society, it must begin with our own sacrifices. It does not matter what career we pursue or the position we hold, as long as we unite our efforts. May we be among those who uphold the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam by serving our communities, just as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent as a mercy to all the worlds. Amin, amin, ya rabbal alamin. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات وذكر الحكيم وتقبل مني ومنكم تلاوته إنه هو السميع العليم أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وعنم وتفضل وبارك وكرم بجلالك وكرامك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد ورضي الله تعالى عن ساداتنا أصحاب الرسول الله أجمعين.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا بربوبيته وإرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الخلائق والبشر اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه مصاحب الغرار أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله تعالى فيما أمر وانتهوا عما نهاكم عنه وزجر Dear Jumaah Rahimakumullah, let us have taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remind ourselves that life on this earth is only temporary and that the hereafter is eternal and everlasting. Therefore, let us prepare ourselves to face the day of judgment. Blessed Friday, Jemaah Rahimakumullah. Recently, we have been shocked by the news of a series of earthquakes that has struck Lombok. In addition to this, we are also saddened by the massive flood which was triggered by a collapsed dam in the Atapeu province in Laos. Many have lost their lives or place of shelter, and their basic necessities were cut off as a result of this disaster. We can only imagine the grief and misery of the communities who live in the affected areas. Those affected will certainly face a great challenge in rebuilding their lives and their country. The spirit to help is one that naturally exists in each and every one of us. So let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them strength to rebuild their lives, to restore peace and security, as well as give them a reprieve from the trials that they are facing. Hence, The Rahmatan Lil Alamin Foundation, in collaboration with mosques throughout Singapore, will be conducting a donation drive for the victims of the earthquake in Lombok, as well as for the flood victims in Laos. Designated donation boxes have been placed in mosques from today until next Thursday, 16 August 2018. Please extend help as much as you are able with utmost sincerity. And may our sincere contribution shine a ray of hope so that those affected will be able to continue on with their lives. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lighten their burdens and give them strength to face this trial. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alamin. Ala sallu wa sallimu ala nabiyyi al-Mustafa khairil anam. Faqad amarana Allahu bidhalika haythu qala fi kitabihi al-aziz. Inna Allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabiy. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي
رضي الله
وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابعي التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وأنا معهم وفيهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم علي بنا كلمة الإسلام وارفع بنا راية القرآن اللهم إنا نسألك أن تفقهنا في ديننا وأن تعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن تنفعنا بما علمتنا اللهم افتح لنا فتحا مبينا واهدنا إلى صراطك صراطا مستقيما وانصرنا نصرا عزيزا وأتم علينا نعمتك وانشر علينا رحمتك وأنزل في قلوبنا سكينتك ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم واسألوه من فضله يعطكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا صفوفكم فإن تسوت الصفوف من تمام الصلاة Dear Jamaah, please keep yourself close and straighten your rows and please fill up the row in front of you to make more space for our brothers who are arriving later. Also, please keep silent your handphone. Para jemaah yang dirahmati Allah, rapatkan barisan dan luruskan saf. Penuhkan saf yang dihadapan supaya memberi ruang kepada saudara kita yang tiba lewat dan harap dapat matikan atau silentkan handphone supaya tidak mengganggu ketenteraman solat. Tarasu wa'atadil wa sya'u fi solatikum irhamni wa irhamkumullah. الله أكبر
الله أكبر
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر.
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 الله Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah.
Astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim. Alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyu al-qayyum wa atubu ilayhim. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام وإليك يعود السلام فهينا ربنا بالسلام وادخلنا الجنة دار السلام تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام إلهنا يا ربنا سبحان الله. سبحان الله وبحمده دائما أبدا الحمد لله الحمد لله على كل نعمة وفي كل حال الله أكبر الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا سبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم أستغفر الله العظيم أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذريتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والحمد لله رب العالمين recite surah al-fatiha and pray for the well-being wellness and spirit recovery to Hajjatul Rabigum Rashidur Rahman and family Hajjatul Arun Edwards Pahin Jamil bin Omar Bapak Haji Nur Salam Tabu Salam Sayyid Muhammad Syahab Al-Hash Haji Umar Kuang Haji Salman Karim Pahin Haji Raya Muhammad Taha Nujim Sa'at Talib Rishal Hajjah Isa Bigum Muhammad Harith Abdullah Muhammad Ibrahim Abdul Rahim Ibrahim Salman Karullah Bapak Bin Hussein and Suhali Samsuddin and Ustaz Terfuling Al-Marhum Al-Marhumah May Allah bless their soul and subject good deeds Haji Nurina Haji Ali, Haji Kusum Abdul Ghani, Haji Isa Haji Ta'in, Datin Haji Rashid Abdullah, Haji Said Siddiq Abdullah Idid, Haji Sani Abdul, Haji Mazda Haji Abdul Rahman, Muhammad Luqman Sayuti, Haji Karullah Mansur, Haji Husain Haji Yusuf, Haji Sabur Haji Sarjimin, and Haji Juraimah binti Juwani. Ala hazin niya wa kritis saliha wa nas'alullah ijabah al-Fatiha.
آمين 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 يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا دعانا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واختم صالحات أعمالنا وآجالنا يا الله يا كريم صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. Amin. Allah minna wa minkum.